Hello, my name is Dr. Carlo Oger. I am an emergency physician with edexitvideo.com, a website that teaches patients about common medical disorders, especially diagnoses coming out of the emergency department. In this video, I want to talk about the Ebola virus, mainly because we just had the first documented case in the United States of making the diagnosis inside of the United States of the Ebola virus. Do I know enough about the Ebola virus? Does my staff know enough about it? How to prevent it? How to treat it? How is it transmitted? These are the kind of things that we will be discussing in this video. Ebola, previously known as Ebola hemorrhagic fever, is a rare and deadly disease caused by infection with one of the Ebola virus strains. Ebola viruses are found in several African countries. Ebola was first discovered in 1976 near the Ebola River in what is now the Democratic Republic of the Congo. Since then, outbreaks have appeared sporadically in Africa. Ebola is caused by an infection with a virus of the family Filoviridae, genus Ebola virus. There are five identified Ebola virus strains, four of which are known to cause disease in humans: the Ebola virus, the Sudan virus, the Thai forest virus, and the Bundibugyo, or whatever you say that, virus. The fifth, the Reston virus, has caused disease in non-human primates, but not in humans. In 2014, right now, Ebola outbreak is the largest Ebola outbreak in history and the first Ebola outbreak in West Africa. This outbreak is the first Ebola epidemic the world has ever known. What are the symptoms of Ebola? These occur 2 to 21 days after exposure, but 8 to 10 days is more common. On the first stage, 7 to 9 days, you get joint pain, sore throat, fever, headache, and weakness, some muscle soreness, or we call those myalgias. On the second stage, around day 10, you get vomiting, blood, diarrhea, high fevers, and extreme fatigue. On the third stage, on the 11th day, brain damage, bleeding from the nose, mouth, or even rectal bleeding. On the fourth stage, which is after the 12th day, there's coma, organ failure, shock, massive internal bleeding, even death. I said before, the symptoms appear anywhere from 2 to 21 days after exposure, but the average is 8 to 10 days. Recovery from Ebola depends on the patient's immune response. People who recover from Ebola infection develop antibodies that last for at least 10 years. The virus can spread in several ways to others. Ebola spread through direct contact, through broken skin or mucous membranes with blood or body fluids, including but not limited to urine, saliva, feces, vomit, and semen. Of a person who is sick with Ebola, for example, objects like needles and syringes that have been contaminated with the virus-infected animals also. Ebola is not spread through air or by water or, in general, food. However, in Africa, Ebola may be spread as a result of handling bushmeat, which is wild animals hunted for food, and contact with infected bats. Healthcare providers caring for Ebola patients and the family and friends in close contact with Ebola patients are at the highest risk of getting sick because they come in contact with infected blood or body fluids of these sick patients. Exposure to Ebola can occur in healthcare settings where the hospital staff are not wearing appropriate protective equipment, including masks, gowns, and gloves, and eye protection. Once someone recovers from Ebola, they can no longer spread the virus. However, Ebola virus has been found in semen for up to 3 months. People who recover from Ebola are advised to abstain from sex or use condoms for at least 3 months. Healthcare workers who may be exposed to people with Ebola should follow these steps: wear protective clothing, including masks, gloves, gowns, and eye protection. Practice proper infection control and sterilization measures. Isolate patients with Ebola from other patients. Avoid direct contact with bodies of people who have died from Ebola. Notify healthcare officials if you have had direct contact with blood or body fluids, such as but not limited to feces, saliva, urine, vomit, and semen of a person who is sick with Ebola. The virus can enter the body through broken skin or unprotected mucous membranes, for example, the eyes, nose, or mouth. Diagnosing Ebola in a person who has been infected for only a few days is difficult because the early symptoms, such as fever, are non-specific to Ebola infection and are seen often in patients with more commonly occurring diseases such as malaria, typhoid fever, or any other kind of viral illness. Honestly, it's most likely for we to diagnose people with viral syndrome, especially now that we're entering flu season, people with fever, myalgias, and body aches. In the first few days, there is really no difference between a viral syndrome and the symptoms of early Ebola infection. However, if a person has the early symptoms of Ebola and has had contact with the blood or body fluids of a person sick with Ebola, contact with objects that have been contaminated with blood or body fluids of a person sick with Ebola, or even the contact with infected animals, they should be isolated and public health professionals notified. The tests that can be done, as you can see on the table above, within a few days of symptoms, later in the disease, and retrospectively when people die. These tests are available, but they take days to come back. So in a person with suspicion of Ebola infection, sure, we're going to test them if they have an exposure or a history of exposure to a person with Ebola, but the tests are not going to come back immediately. What about the treatment then? The symptoms of Ebola are treated as they show up. They follow basic interventions when used early can significantly improve the chances of survival, providing IV fluids and balancing the electrolytes, maintaining oxygen and blood pressure, and treating other infections if they occur. Some experimental treatments developed for Ebola have been tested and proven to be effective in animals, but have not yet been tested in randomized human trials. Of course, we know the experience with a recent physician that came back with the Ebola to the United States and had an antibody injection, and he recovered well. This is an informational flyer that I found on the internet, tackling the deadly Ebola virus. I think the important thing here shows you the areas in the Africa that it's involved in. But also one of the key facts is show Ebola virus can be used as bioterrorism tool, which will lead to high casualties and panic around the world. The virus can be easily transmitted from one person to the other, but it's not through the respiratory route. And the virus has a 90% mortality rate. So not everybody dies, but only 10% survive. This is a clinical picture of a patient with the hemorrhage that is caused by this hemorrhagic fever virus. In the next few slides, I'm going to show some very graphic pictures. So if you're going to get upset or you can't handle it, don't watch this. But this is what the disease can develop into. You get bleeding out of mucous membranes, nose, eyes, mouth, the GI tract with vomiting blood or rectal bleeding. You got the hemorrhagic purpura with hemorrhagic blisters. You get the same kind of effect around the face, and there's plenty of other pictures in the internet that you can find as well. I hope you learned a lot with this video, and if you want to watch other educational videos, go visit my YouTube channel, The EdExit Video, or edexitvideo.com. Thank you for watching this video. Bye-bye.